back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we have a question that was sent in by Richard. I actually met Richard. He came to one of my live seminars last week and then mailed this question in the next day. He says, how do you copy a formula horizontally when it's reading from a vertical list? I thought that was a great question. It's kind of tricky the way that we're going to do that. We have a vertical list in column A from A3 to A12, and I've now entered a formula that grabs item 1, but when I copy that across, of course, it's not going to work, because it will point to the wrong cells. The approach to this is kind of amazing, and I'm going to take you kind of down a strange path here. I want to talk about the column function. The column function, we'll use equal column, and I always want to point to something in column A, let's just say A1. Equal column of A1 is a very fancy way of writing the number 1. Column of A1 says what column is column A? It's the first column. Now, the beautiful thing about this, though, is when I copy it across, column of A1 changes to column of B1, which is a fancy way of saying 2. Then I get 3, 4, 5, 6. So the column is going to be the solution here. We're going to use equal index. The index says we have either a vertical or a rectangular range. I'm going to hit the F4 key to make sure that that is an absolute reference. And then which item do I want? Which row number do I want to go to? Well, I want to go to column A1. In other words, the first item in the list. Because this only has one column, I don't have to put a comma 1 at the end. Normally, you'd have to put a comma and say, which column you're trying to go from, but in this case it's just a nice simple list. So we'll choose that, and you'll see that we get item 1, but now as we copy to the right, column of A1 changes to column of B1, and that says give me item 2, item 3, item 4, item 5, item 6, right across. Completely unintuitive to have to use two functions that you probably have never used, the index function and the column function, but a very simple way to solve this rather hard problem. Thanks to Richard for coming out to the seminar and for sending this question in. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.